Well, a new exhibition exploring the resilience of Australia's First Peoples has launched in the nation's capital. Bringing together the work of 30 Indigenous artists, Defying Empire marks the ongoing resistance and defiance by Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people against colonisation from first contact until today. Nakari Thorpe went along to check it out.
Confronting, haunting and defiant. The work of 30 Indigenous artists, Defying Empire is one of the largest shows of First Nations work, and it's at the cutting edge of contemporary art.
The weaving impressed me very much. The beautiful little handheld baskets and the big wall one. It was extremely well done.
Blown away by the range of ways that people approach their own feelings and their own past and some of the damage that people have experienced in the past, but different ways that people heal through art.
The show is a salute to ongoing Indigenous defiance. Its launch coincided with the 50th anniversary of the 1967 referendum, and it doesn't shy away from challenging and complex issues of race, identity and displacement.
This exhibition is special. This one is really asking 30 talented Indigenous artists to make strong comments about what it is to be Indigenous in today's Australia.
It's a personal story, it's a political story, it's a story of survival, but it's also a story of trauma and hardship.
And it challenges our ideas of Aboriginal culture, and it shows how sophisticated we continue to be in this country despite the adversity that we've faced.
Quandamooka artist Megan Cope hails from North Stradbroke Island in Queensland. She uses maps, language and the environment to challenge notions of ownership and connection to country.
They're about decolonising our environments and, you know, imagining what if we saw Aboriginal language as a dominant language, you know, and reading, yeah, seeing ourselves in that space as the dominant culture.
Ray Ken is an Anangu Pitjantjatjara elder. He's telling me about his four works on display. He says they tell the story of when young people will need to look after country and how important it is to keep culture and connection strong so that nothing can take it away. Defying Empire is the third National Indigenous Art Triennial opened here at the National Gallery of Australia. Its extraordinary work is testament to the cultural and human wealth of a people that same empire tried to erase.
Some of these works are very tough. They're very confronting and they're going to prove very controversial. But that's a fantastic thing, because this is a kind of an opportunity to ask this broad group of contemporary Indigenous practitioners to make a comment about all of these issues.
For the public, I would hope that they, when they look at these beautiful artworks, that they not only appreciate the beautiful aesthetics, but that they look further and they see that underlying stories. Of survival, of triumph, of oppression and dispossession.
Well, for me, it's quite heart-wrenching, emotional effect that it has upon you. But what a wonderful way of these artists to express their feelings of former injustices.
In my country, we're in the process of reconciliation with Indigenous populations, and that exhibition is a good example of what should be done.
Yeah, I just think it's very moving. It really is, it's quite moving, you know, to see different aspects.
The exhibition is open until September 10.